आज हमारे बीच में हमारे मुख्य अतिथि श्री नितिन गडकर जी उपस्थित हैं। आई विल रिक्वेस्ट माय टीम टू फैसिलिटेट, वी वुड लाइक टू हैव द लॉन्च ऑफ द स्टार्टअप ग्रो प्रोग्राम एट द ऑगस्ट हैंड ऑफ ऑनरेबल श्री नितिन गडकर जी। Thank you, Team iHub, for this wonderful occasion. We are grateful to Honorable Minister Nitin Gadkari ji to grace this occasion and launch this program. May I now request Nitin Gadkari ji, Honorable Minister for Road, Transport, Highways and MSME Government of India, to bless us.
My friend, Honorable Minister Sri Bhupendra Singh Chudasama ji, Anush Sharma, Principal Secretary for Higher and Technical Education from Government of Gujarat, all respectable dignitaries and dear friends, it's a pleasure and pride for me for inaugurating new initiative related with the startup, and this initiative which has taken by the Honorable Education Minister of Gujarat, Adaraniya Bhupendra Singh Chudasama ji and his department. I am giving my special thanks and my best wishes to all of you, those who are part of this mission. I always feel that the innovation, entrepreneurship, science, technology, research, skilled and successful practices, we name it as a knowledge, and conversion of knowledge into wealth is the future for the country. And this point of view, it is very important to guide properly to the students who are the future citizen of our country. Our mission, which is given by Prime Minister Modi ji to all of us, to make India Atmanirbhar Bharat. Exactly what is the mission of Atmanirbhar Bharat is to create more employment potential, to create more wealth by which we can eradicate the poverty, but at the same time we can make India as a number one global economy. For that reason, we need to increase our export and reduce our imports. The way in which we need to plan our economy in a way by which we will create more employment potential. We have a lot of people, we name it as wealth creator. At the same time, they are employment creator. And to create employment is a most important thing for the country. Creating employment, we are going to resolve not only the poverty problem, but we are making Indian economy number one global economy in the global world, number one economy. And that is exactly the mission for all of us. Only the thing which I want to request you, in our total GDP, our 8 to 10% growth is coming from agriculture and related industries, agriculture and agro processing industries, 22 to 24% from the manufacturing sector, and 52 to 56% growth is GDP growth is coming from service sector. Now presently, at the time of 1947, our 85% of the population was from the rural area. Today the 30% population is migrated from rural India to urban India. But our growth is from this 85% of the population, which once upon a time is a strength for the country. Now lot of people now migrated from rural India, agriculture India, to urban India. Here we need to concentrate more on agriculture and rural area. Presently, our village industry turnover is 80,000 crore. And as a MSME, now we have decided to make this turnover up to 5 lakh crore within 2 years. Actually, MSME contribute 30% of the growth rate. 48% of the export of the country is from MSME. up till now we have created 11 crore jobs. And now idea is to create 5 crore new jobs. My only request to all of you that we need to concentrate more on agriculture, rural and tribal sector, where our economic growth is very negligible. The 115 aspirant districts, the area from agriculture, rural, tribal, where it's a forest area, where we are facing the problem of unemployment, poverty, problem related with education, health services, all social infrastructure is less compared with the urban area. So now in this area, what are the raw materials are available? What type of new initiative we can take? What type of new initiative by which we can make our economy strong in the rural and agriculture area? This is the highest priority where our country is needed for that. I will give you my all best wishes to for all this new initiative. But I will request you that can you divide it into two parts? Some of the startups, some of the technology which are related with the industry, particularly for urban area, and some of the industry where we can make the taking the use of raw material which is available in the rural agriculture and tribal area by which we can make our economy strong in that area. I'm giving you an example. In India, we have got now sugar surplus. Last year, we have exported sugar of 60 lakh ton and we give the subsidy of 6,000 crore for that. Now, it is a challenge with the economy. For sugar cane, we are considering the price of sugar 34 rupees per kg. The international price and market price in international market is 22 rupees per kg. So now this is a situation that our sugar mills and sugar farmers, sugar cane farmers are facing crucial problem. So government has taken a decision to that we can make ethanol from sugar cane juice, from molasses. In place of sugar, we will convert sugar into ethanol. Ethanol is a green fuel. And as a transport minister, we have already launched bike scooter on 100% bioethanol. Ethanol is proved to be better fuel, good fuel than petrol. Less pollution, it's a green fuel. And now the TVS and Bajaj both have launched their motorcycle and scooter on bioethanol. Now we are adding ethanol in petrol, 22% we are decided, but up till now only we are adding 5% ethanol because ethanol is not available. But now the size of ethanol economy is 20,000 crore and we are going to make it ethanol economy of 2 lakh crore, where 1 lakh crore directly will go into the pocket of the farmers. Now the one of the institution in India, the Praj Industries from Pune, they have successfully make all experiments making bio aviation fuel from ethanol. So we can now already we have successfully run our helicopters and fighter jet by using 100% bio aviation fuel on ethanol. We have taken initiative taking spice jet from Dehradun to Delhi by using 25% bio aviation fuel. So we can make this fuel from ethanol. We can make diesel from Ratanjot, Moha, Sal, Karanj and Toli, which is available in the forest area. So there are a lot of new ideas. The Khadi Gramodyog Commission is already doing a lot of good things. At 12th January, Mr. Saxena, our chairman from Khadi Gramodyog Commission, is from Gujarat. And we are launching a paint. And the paint is named as, the paint is from the cow dung, that gobar. And that quality of the paint is so good as compared with the Nerolac and Asian. That quality we are achieved. We have got the laboratory test. And the rate of paint from making from that gobar is 225 rupees per liter. And Asian paint and other big brands, Nerolac, they have 525 to 550 rupees per liter. The quality is good. So this type of innovation and startup is going to helpful to the poor people, to the farmers. And we need to think on the line that how we can make our rural economy strong. How we can make the available raw material, waste material, which are available in the agriculture and rural area. Now, for considering that regarding this cotton straw, wheat straw, rice straw, bagasse, we can get bio CNG from that. And in Nagpur, in my own city, my own tractor from Mahindra, 15 years old tractor, we have taken initiative to convert it into bio-CNG. We have converted 100 buses of Nagpur on bio-CNG, and now our idea is to convert tractors on bio-CNG. So one tractor, when we convert from diesel to bio-CNG, the saving is 1 lakh rupees per year for the farmer. That is going to be a great benefit for him. So this type of new innovation, which are very much useful for the rural, tribal and agriculture area, where I will request you to concentrate more on it, using that material, you will get the thing from that. For example, I'm giving an example of municipal solid waste and liquid waste. The already we have also successfully make the experiment successfully that we are selling the toilet water, sewage water of Nagpur to government of Maharashtra, getting 325 crore rupees royalty per year. Now we are trying to take it methane from that water and bifurcate methane from CO2 to get bio-CNG, and that bio-CNG we want to use it for transport. The CO2 is available all over in the country, everywhere. It is a really a great pollution is a big problem. So is there is any startup where they can use making CO2 as a raw material, and from CO2 they can make some value addition in it? Not only that dry ice or methanol or ethanol is there, but now there is a technology available that you can convert CO2 into that SIM gas. And SIM gas can be used as an alternative for LPG. LPG we are importing. So this type of new technology, which are related with the agriculture, rural, tribal area, 115 aspirant districts, where you need to focus that what are the raw material available in that area and what type of technology where we can take the advantage of it. For the MSME, upgradation of technology is very important. We need to reduce logistic cost, labor cost, power cost, ultimately the production cost. Now, for example, I am telling you, if going by road, the cost is 10 rupees. Going by railway cost is 6 rupees, for example. And going by waterways is only 1 rupees. I remember when I was Minister for Shipping, I take initiative for MPBS seaplane. And now in Gujarat also, they are trying to make the experiment, successful experiment using MPBS seaplane. It can change the total transport sector. So this type of new innovation is going to increase employment potential in the country, but not employment potential. It can going to increase tourism in the country by using catamaran, hovercrafts, then airboats, MPBS seaplanes, electric system, particularly electric power trail buses. So this is the future. Now I'm making this Mumbai-Delhi Express Highway, which is going through Gujarat. Already 50% work has completed. The cost of the highway is 1 lakh crore. And this highway, it will be easy from going to Delhi to Mumbai within 12 hours. It is an access control highway. So on that highway, my idea is to make electric highway, where just like railway, the two buses will taking the advantage of the cable by which electricity will get it, and they will run by the speed of 120 km per hour. So a lot of new innovation is there. So everywhere the knowledge is changing. Successful practices are different. But people like you, where I will request you that what is the priority for our focus? So this focus is very important. I don't know what are the raw materials which are available in Gujarat. I don't know what is the strength of tourism in Gujarat. I don't know what is the agriculture produce which are in Gujarat, that how we can make it. What is the forest, where what type of industry we can making a forest based material we can use. How we can develop khadi village. We have denim. That khadi denim is now exported to USA. The company name as Levi's, something they are making jeans. They are using that khadi denim. We have successfully making shoes and chappals, ladies chappals, by using Banaras silk on the upper side of the shoes and that chappals. And we are using khadi denim there. Mr. Saxena is there already in Gujarat. Please call him. He can give you the lot of new idea related with khadi and Gram Udyog Mission. The honey, there is a huge potential is available. You can make chocolates and everything. I remember in Wardha districts, where we have one biscuit name as Gorus Park. They are taking ghee from cows, then milk from cows, then honey. So it's a so tasty biscuit that I never tasted this biscuit like Gorus Park. It is really good for the health. And if we can make different quality on it, making pineapple flavor, orange flavor, huge market is available. So my suggestion is, the what are the raw materials available in Gujarat, in the rural agriculture tribal area? At the same time, you should think about industries, about innovation, about information technology, about biotechnology is equally important. I am not going to tell you that giving second priority to it, but you should focus on all with the integrated approach, not only on urban sector, on industry, on IT, on biotechnology, because the information technology and biotechnology is the future. The conversion of waste into wealth and conversion of knowledge into wealth, the both things are there. And the young generation is very talented. They are taking initiative. All the startups are doing excellent jobs. The Prime Minister is always talking about this, all which you are doing that, particularly for the people of different, using the electronics in it, we can make this khilone, different type of it. The Prime Minister was giving idea to that it should be related with our history, by which people, our student, can understand what is our history by using the making. It is not only for entertainment, it is for getting knowledge from that. So I feel that your initiative is very important. Giving opportunity to the student is very important. And you are supporting startup, and this startup you are spending 20 crore rupees. But I am giving you the assurance that the people from this startup, they are going to save for the future, for the country, for 2000 crore. Because the innovation, entrepreneurship, science, technology, research, skill, successful practices, and upgradation of the technology is the future. And it is a continuous process. And for that reason, we need to support a talented, young, talented people, students, who has got the ability, who can deliver the future, the generation, their knowledge. And the knowledge is the most important thing for the country. And where you are taking the initiative, it really giving me a great pleasure from my department, MSME. We will support your all ideas. If anywhere, if in our own schemes, if you need some financial support, we will think on that line to support you. I am giving my special thanks to all organizers, stakeholders, and particularly the students who are taking initiative in startup, and giving, you are taking lot of making new schemes by which you are giving encouragement to the students. And I am confident that these students who are encouraged by you, in the future, they will become the scientists, they will contribute for the country, and 100% they will give new vision to our country to make India Atmanirbhar Bharat. And that is exactly the dream. Because of all this new talented startup, we are going to increase our export, reducing our imports, and where we are going to make India a number one global economy. Your path is very, very appropriate and correct way you are interpreting the policy, and you are trying to fulfill the dream of our Prime Minister. And it is exactly the line of Atmanirbhar Bharat. I am really giving my thanks to all of you and Honorable Minister, all officers and students, stakeholders, and particularly the students who are taking initiative in it. I am giving my best wishes for New Year, and also for best wishes for their all new ventures. Thank you very much. Namaskar.